Happy learning MATLAB and have a good day. Welcome to another tutorial on MATLAB. In the last tutorial, we have seen the concept of sample time. The sample time that we have seen can be varied over time. Based on that, we will see what are the different methods to vary the sample time and what MATLAB offers to see how we can use the sampling time. So in this tutorial, we will see what is fixed and what is variable type of solvers and how they implement this particular implementation or how they vary the sample time. So coming to the fixed type solver, in this one, the sample time will always be fixed. So when you go for any fixed sample time, then the sample time will be fixed before starting the simulation, and that will stay same throughout the simulation. So this is called fixed type of solver, and the concept of solvers comes when you want to solve something based on one particular simulation time. That we will see in the next tutorial. But for now, like, we need to know where the fixed type of solvers should be used. So when you go for the code generation part, then you will be using a fixed type solver. Why you will be using a fixed type solver? Because there is a clock frequency that is assigned for every hardware, and that will be fixed always. So when you go for the code generation, then you need to set your model setting to fixed type solver, and then you need to use the code generation tool. Otherwise, you will get error, because for variable type solver, you cannot generate the code. As it is obvious that the hardware that you will be using is having a defined clock frequency, that means it will have a defined sample time. And that is why the fixed type solver is being created, and you can use it for that particular purpose. Coming to the variable type solver, what basically the variable type solver does? So when you are trying to collect the sample time, and the difference between these two are very big compared to it should be, then in that case, there are some inbuilt mechanism through which it will check whether the selected sample time is proper or not. If the selected sample time is not suitable, then either it will try to increase the sample time or it will try to decrease the sample time. Suppose the error is very large, then in that case, the sample time will be decreased to increase the precision of the measurement that is happening through this sample interval or samplings. That way, you can see the behavior of the system based on its dynamic, and you can also analyze the system behavior based on its dynamics, how the values are changing, how fast it is changing over time. This helps us to analyze the model that we developed, and through variable type solver, we can try to figure out what is the proper sample time that it should be having, which means the system should be having, so that you can solve it or you can collect the data properly. So this is all about the variable type solver. When you select the variable type solver, the main intention is to analyze the model, and based on that, you will be able to also judge the model or judge the system. But once it is all done, you can set a fixed type solver for the same model. And suppose you want to generate the code, then you can again use this fixed type solver to generate the code. But the main purpose of variable type solver is to analyze the model and also solve it properly using the error methods that are there inside these solvers, which we will see in the next tutorial how this is being implemented and what are the different type of solvers that are there in MATLAB or Simulink, which will be enabling us to run a particular system model in a proper way. So here always the sample time will be updated based on the system dynamics, and always an error will be calculated based on which this particular variable or the sample time is updated. The key summary over this particular tutorial is, when you are using a fixed type solver, then you will be able to generate the code from your model. And if you are using a variable type solver, the main purpose over here is to analyze the model, what you are having and what you have created. In case you are liking the channel, please consider subscribing for the latest updated videos in our channel. In case you have any comment or suggestion, please share it in the comment box so that we can improve your learning experience in this particular channel. Have a great day and happy learning, MATLAB.